Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I am Smriti Rastogi with news tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. India moving towards being a strong, secure and inclusive nation under Modi-led NDA government, says President Ramnath Kovind in his address to joint sitting of Parliament. Unveils government's roadmap in its second term, underscores national security and realizing goals for New India by 2022 as priorities. The 249th session of Rajya Sabha starts with tabling of copy of President's address. Two Rajya Sabha members from Assam sworn in. Prime Minister introduces Council of Ministers in the House. Top priority for public interest issues in Rajya Sabha. Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu tells floor leaders of all parties that upper house should be a worthy example for legislative assemblies in states. Huge blow to former Chief Minister Chandrababu Naidu's TDP in Andhra Pradesh. Four of the party's six Rajya Sabha members joined BJP. Submit letter of resignation from TDP to Chairman Naidu. And India to lead world in celebrating International Yoga Day. Many events organized across the country. Prime Minister Narendra Modi to do yoga in Jharkhand's capital Ranchi along with thousands of residents. President Ramnath Kovind addressed the joint sitting of both the Houses of Parliament on Thursday. Congratulating the voters for the clear mandate, President Kovind said that over 61 crore citizens cast their vote to set a new record. He said people voted to continue with the development of the country that began in 2014. Congratulating the newly elected MPs, President Kovind said that new government is committed to Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. He said the government was moving ahead to create a strong, secure and inclusive India. He said that a large number of women MPs have been elected this time in the history of Lok Sabha, presenting a picture of New India.
Meri sarkar rashtra nirman ki us soch ke prati sankalpit hai जिसकी नींव वर्ष 2014 में रखी गई थी. देशवासियों की मूलभूत आवश्यकताएं पूरी करते हुए अब सरकार उनकी आकांक्षाओं के अनुरूप एक सशक्त, सुरक्षित, समृद्ध और सर्वसमावेशी भारत के निर्माण की दिशा में आगे बढ़ रही है. यह यात्रा सबका साथ, सबका विकास और सबका विश्वास की मूल भावना से प्रेरित है. सरकार की यह सोच है कि न केवल महिलाओं का विकास हो बल्कि महिलाओं के नेतृत्व में विकास हो. महिला सुरक्षा को सर्वोच्च प्राथमिकता देते हुए राज्यों के सहयोग से अनेक प्रभावी कदम उठाए गए हैं. महिलाओं के विरुद्ध अपराधों के दंड अधिक सख्त बनाए गए हैं और नए दंड प्रावधानों को सख्ती से लागू किया जा रहा है.
In his address, President Kovind listed achievements of the NDA government, their various schemes and benefits, including Prime Minister Farmer Kisan Samman Nidhi and pension scheme for the farmers and small businesses.
जो किसान हमारा अन्न दाता है उसकी सम्मान राशि की पहुंच बढ़ाते हुए अब प्रधानमंत्री किसान सम्मान निधि को देश के प्रत्येक किसान के लिए उपलब्ध कराने का निर्णय लिया गया. अपने खेत में दिन रात काम करने वाले किसान भाई बहन 60 वर्ष की आयु के बाद भी सम्मानजनक जीवन बिता सकें, इसे ध्यान में रखते हुए किसानों से जुड़ी पेंशन योजना को भी स्वीकृति दी जा चुकी है। सरकार ने कृषि नीति को उत्पादन केंद्रित रखने के साथ साथ आय केंद्रित भी बनाया है। इन्हीं प्रयासों की एक महत्वपूर्ण कड़ी है प्रधानमंत्री किसान सम्मान निधि। इसके माध्यम से सिर्फ 3 महीने में ही 12,000 करोड़ रुपए से अधिक की राशि किसानों के पास पहुंचाई जा चुकी है। हर किसान को इस योजना के दायरे में लाए जाने के बाद अब इस योजना पर प्रतिवर्ष लगभग 90,000 करोड़ रुपए खर्च होने का अनुमान है। जवान जो सीमा पर डटा रहता है, जिसकी वजह से सभी देशवासी निश्चिंत रहते हैं, उसके बच्चों के भविष्य को सुरक्षित करना भी हमारा दायित्व है। इसी भावना से प्रेरित होकर नेशनल डिफेंस फंड से वीर जवानों के बच्चों को मिलने वाली स्कॉलरशिप की राशि बढ़ा दी गई है। इसमें पहली बार राज्य पुलिस के जवानों के बेटे बेटियों को भी शामिल किया गया है। इलाज के खर्च से गरीब परिवार आर्थिक संकट में फंस जाते हैं, उन्हें इस संकट से बचाने के लिए 50 करोड़ गरीबों को स्वास्थ्य सुरक्षा कवच प्रदान करने वाली विश्व की सबसे बड़ी हेल्थ केयर स्कीम आयुष्मान भारत योजना लागू की गई। इसके तहत अब तक लगभग 26 लाख गरीब मरीजों को अस्पताल में इलाज की सुविधा दी जा चुकी है। सस्ती दरों पर दवा उपलब्ध कराने के लिए 5,300 जन औषधि केंद्र भी खोले जा चुके हैं। क्लाइमेट चेंज और ग्लोबल वार्मिंग के बढ़ते प्रभावों के कारण आने वाले समय में जल संकट के और गहराने की आशंका है। आज समय की मांग है कि जिस तरह देश ने स्वच्छ भारत अभियान को लेकर गंभीरता दिखाई है, वैसी ही गंभीरता जल संरक्षण एवं प्रबंधन के विषय में भी दिखानी होगी।
माननीय सदस्यगण, He said the government was taking effective steps towards national security and tackling the threat of terrorism.
नया भारत संवेदनशील भी होगा और आर्थिक रूप से समृद्ध भी, लेकिन इसके लिए देश का सुरक्षित होना बहुत जरूरी है। मेरी सरकार राष्ट्रीय सुरक्षा को सर्वोच्च प्राथमिकता देती है। यही कारण है कि आतंकवाद और नक्सलवाद से निपटने के लिए प्रभावी कदम उठाए जा रहे हैं। सीमा पार आतंकवादी ठिकानों पर पहले सर्जिकल स्ट्राइक और फिर पुलवामा हमले के बाद एयर स्ट्राइक करके भारत ने अपने इरादों और क्षमताओं को प्रदर्शित किया है। भविष्य में भी अपनी सुरक्षा के लिए हर संभव कदम उठाए जाएंगे। जलवायु परिवर्तन हो, आर्थिक और साइबर अपराध हो, भ्रष्टाचार और काले धन पर कार्रवाई हो या फिर ऊर्जा सुरक्षा, हर मुद्दे पर भारत के विचारों को विश्व समुदाय समर्थन देता है। आज आतंकवाद के मुद्दे पर पूरा विश्व भारत के साथ खड़ा है। देश में बड़े आतंकी हमलों के लिए जिम्मेदार मसूद अजहर को संयुक्त राष्ट्र द्वारा अंतर्राष्ट्रीय आतंकी घोषित करना इसका बहुत बड़ा प्रमाण है। मेरी सरकार की नेबरहुड फर्स्ट की नीति दक्षिण एशिया एवं निकटवर्ती क्षेत्रों को प्राथमिकता देने की हमारी सोच का प्रमाण है। इस वर्ष इस पूरे क्षेत्र की प्रगति में भारत की महत्वपूर्ण भूमिका होगी। यही कारण है कि इस क्षेत्र में व्यापार कनेक्टिविटी और पीपल टू पीपल कॉन्टैक्ट को प्रोत्साहित किया जा रहा है।
And after President Ramnath Kovind's joint address to both the Houses of Parliament, the 249th session of the Rajya Sabha commenced on Thursday. Prime Minister Narendra Modi introduced his Council of Ministers in the Rajya Sabha on the first day of the budget session.
The 249th session of Rajya Sabha started on Thursday. In the first session after the 2019 general elections, Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu informed the members that Thavarchand Gehlot will be the leader of the House.
That Sri Thavarchand Gehlot, Minister of Social Justice and Empowerment, has been nominated as the leader of the House in Rajya Sabha by the Honorable Prime Minister.
According to tradition, he also introduced Prime Minister Narendra Modi to the House and asked him to introduce his new council of ministers to the Rajya Sabha.
Maniya Desh Mahoday, main aapki anumati se, aapse aur aapke madhyam se, is sammanit sadasya apne mantri parishad ke sahyogiyon ka parichay karana chahta hoon.
Prime Minister Modi read out names and portfolios of ministers. It's a customary practice to introduce the Council of Ministers after a new government takes over or if there is a reshuffle of the Union Cabinet.
Shri Nitin Jayaram Gadkari, Sadak Parivahan aur Rajmarg Mantri aur Micro, Small and Medium Enterprise Mantri. Shri D.V. Sadanand Gowda, Chemicals and Fertilizer Mantri. Srimati Nirmala Sitaraman, Vitt Mantri aur Corporate Karya Mantri.
Besides Prime Minister, the Council of Ministers has 57 members, 24 cabinet, 9 ministers of state and 24 minister of states with independent charge. Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
Mahila aur Bal Vikas Mantralay mein Rajya Mantri.
Vice President and Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu has sought cooperation of all the political parties for smooth functioning of the upper house. During a luncheon meet at his residence on Thursday, Naidu called upon the floor leaders of the house to accord top priority to fulfilling people's aspirations. He stressed on the need for all members to uphold the dignity and decorum of the house always and adopt the best parliamentary practices and traditions. Further, he also expressed concern over the increasing trend of disrupting the proceedings in the parliament and legislatures, saying parliamentary forums should not be reduced to disruptive platforms. He urged all parties to keep aside their political differences and strive for building a new India. And some other big developments of the day. In a big jolt to end Chandrababu Naidu-led TDP, four of its six Rajya Sabha MPs joined the BJP on Thursday. Y.S. Chaudhary, CM Ramesh, G. Mohan Rao and T.G. Venkatesh met Rajya Sabha Chairman M. Venkaiah Naidu. They handed him a letter of a resolution passed by the legislature party urging its merger with the BJP. BJP's working president J.P. Nadda and leader of the BJP in Rajya Sabha, Thawar Chand Gehlot, also met the vice president and submitted a proposal from BJP President Amit Shah, saying the party has no objection to the merger of the TDP legislature party with the BJP. Later, three of the four MPs met J.P. Nadda and Thawar Chand Gehlot at the party headquarters and formally joined the BJP.
Maniya Rashtriya Adhyaksh ji ne usko swikriti di aur swikriti dene ke paschat main aur Thawar Chand ji us patra ke saath Bharat ke uprashtrapati aur hamare Rajya Sabha ke chairman श्री वेंकैया नायडू जी के पास गए और हमने वो पत्र इनका भी प्रस्ताव और इसके साथ साथ हमारी स्वीकृति का प्रस्ताव ये दोनों प्रस्ताव माननीय उपराष्ट्रपति जी को दिया है और वो उस पर कार्रवाई करेंगे भारतीय जनता पार्टी का तेलुगु देशम पार्टी राज्यसभा की का विलय इसको स्वीकृति भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने दी है
वी शुड जॉइन इन बिल्डिंग दिस ग्रेट नेशन That's one of the reasons. Particularly for me, I also have got an experience having worked for 3.5 years as MOS with the Honorable Prime Minister as the leader of the cabinet. So this decision was taken mainly to join in building the nation and particularly for the state of Andhra Pradesh.
Reacting to the development, TDP Chief N. Chandrababu Naidu said such crises were not new to the party. According to the news reports, Naidu is currently in Europe. He spoke to a couple of senior party leaders over phone and inquired about the rebellion. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi hosted a dinner for members of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha on Thursday. Invites were sent to all the members of both the houses. Among those who attended the dinner include leader of the opposition in Rajya Sabha and Congress leader Gulam Nabi Azad, Various leaders of the ruling NDA DMK's Kanimuri, Aam Aadmi Party Rajya Sabha member Sanjay Singh and three of four TDP Rajya Sabha members who joined the BJP on Thursday. The dinner meeting comes a day after Prime Minister Modi convened a meeting with the presidents of all the political parties on a range of issues, including smooth functioning of the parliament. And now the news from the budget session. Rural development has received undivided attention by the Modi government. The allocation for rural development has increased through the consecutive budgets presented by the government during its five-year term from 2014. The Union Budget 2019-20 is expected to keep primary focus towards enhancing rural economy and infrastructure. Kriti Mishra brings us this report.
After the Defence Ministry, it's only the Rural Development Ministry whose share in budgetary support has been increasing. The budget for the Rural Development Ministry for 2019-20 stands at 1,17,647 crore rupees. That's an increase of 5,244 crore rupees over the revised estimates of 2018-19. The National Rural Livelihood Mission had a 56% hike in funds, the highest among all rural schemes in the interim budget. Allocation for MNREGA was also increased 9% to 60,000 rupees for 2019-20. Under the Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana, construction of rural roads has been trebled. Pakka roads have connected 15.8 lakh out of 17.84 lakh habitations. Budget 2019 is expected to focus on the rural economy as part of the government's larger plan to transform the rural sector. Experts are demanding introduction of technology-intensive processes in the non-farm sector and treating solar energy as third crop to augment income of rural India.
Solar is a big piece of where the rural economy can grow. A lot of us have asked for solar being treated as the third crop, subsidizing the usage of solar panels for farmers, looking at also giving solar pumps like the Chhattisgarh state has done very successfully to farmers where irrigation is a challenge.
The restructured Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen that targets housing for all by 2022 is also expected to get the finance minister's attention. 2.95 crore houses are expected to be built by 2022. As many as 1.07 crore rural houses have been completed in the last 4 years.
The people in the rural area will get to work to build these houses. They will be involved in making these houses. So there is a vibration in the rural area also in terms of the economy, because the money will go to their hand. The jo kaam karenge unko bhi milega. Those who are going to stay, they will be benefiting. Those who are supplying the goods, because you know, most of the time logistics play a major role.
For a stronger economy, India's rural economy needs to grow. And in the second term of the Modi government, efforts to improve the rural sector are expected to witness greater momentum. Kriti Mishra, Rajya Sabha TV.
Ministry of External Affairs on Thursday rejected a Pakistani media report claiming New Delhi was ready for talks with Islamabad. Addressing the media, MEA spokesperson Ravish Kumar said that Prime Minister Narendra Modi and External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar had only sent letters in response to congratulatory messages from their counterparts in that country. He said that in their messages, they have highlighted that India seeks normal and cooperative relations with all neighbours, including Pakistan. And for this, it is important to build an environment of trust free of terror, violence and hostility.
I don't think there is any change in our position. I think we have made it very clear time and again that Pakistan has to take action which is verifiable, has to take action which is irreversible. Unless we are convinced that action has been taken on the ground and not the temporary action which we have seen several times in the past, they really have to take some action and something which can be verified. So we will not be fooled by some cosmetic action here and there. I think some concrete action has to come from their side.
And some other developments, at least 25 people were killed and 35 severely injured when a bus fell into a deep drain in Kulu in district of Himachal Pradesh on Thursday. The private bus fell into the over 300 meter deep gorge near Dothmur in Banjar Tehsil of the district. The bus was on its way to Gadha Gosheni, adding that the rescue operation took place . And in a Twitter message, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu has said, and I quote, "Deeply saddened to know about the bus accident in Kulu, Himachal Pradesh, in which about 25 people lost their lives and many more were injured. My heartfelt condolences to the bereaved families. I wish a speedy recovery of the injured," unquote. Another news from Bihar, where three more children suffering from acute encephalitis syndrome have died, taking the total number of deaths caused due to the outbreak to 118. Government-run SKMC Hospital has reported 97 deaths so far, while 138 children in the age group of 1 to 10 years are still undergoing treatment. 398 children have been admitted to the hospital with AES since June 1st. 20 deaths have been reported from the other hospital in the district. Both hospitals have registered a total of 552 cases of the acute encephalitis syndrome. Meanwhile, a 15-member central team of doctors and paramedical staff have joined the team providing treatment to encephalitis-affected children in Muzaffarpur. And the Union Health Minister, Dr. Harshvardhan, has issued instructions for deployment of 8 advanced life support ambulances in the affected districts. June 21st will mark the 5th International Day of Yoga. Multiple events have been planned across the country to celebrate the day on Friday. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will lead the country in celebrating the occasion by participating in a mega event in Ranchi. All necessary arrangements have been made at the Prabhat Tara ground in Ranchi for the yoga event. BJP President Amit Shah will take part in the event in Rohtak in Haryana, while Defence Minister Rajnath Singh will attend an early morning yoga session at Rajpath in the national capital. Other union ministers and leaders will also be taking part in the Yoga Day events across the city. The slogan for International Yoga Day this year is Yoga for Climate Action. The day is celebrated worldwide on 21st June since 2015. And my colleague Mohammed Fateh Tipu spoke to Ayush Minister Shripad Yesso Nayak on the preparations for the mega event in Ranchi, from where Prime Minister Modi will lead the country in celebrating the International Day of Yoga. Let's listen in.
Antarashtriya Yoga Divas ki mezbani Ranchi kar raha hai is baar hamare sath Ayush Mantri Shripad Nayak ji hain. Mantri ji, Ranchi ko aakhir kyon chuna aapne is mega event ke liye?
अब तो आप तो जानते हैं कि 2015 में से पहला योगा डे, इंटरनेशनल योगा डे हमने दिल्ली में राजपथ पर सेलिब्रेट किया। उसके बाद में हमने सोचा कि एक ही जगह करने के बजाय यदि हम अलग अलग राज्यों में गए जाए तो उसके लिए एक ज़्यादा सपोर्ट उसी राज्य का ज़्यादा सपोर्ट मिलेगा और हम तो सक्सेसफुल हो गए और बहुत सपोर्ट, क्योंकि एक इतना बड़ा योगा का कार्यक्रम होने के बाद एक ऐसा माहौल बनता है, लोगों को पता चलता है मैंने भी करना चाहिए, लोग जुड़ते हैं और सब वातावरण योगामय हो जाता है। इसके पीछे का मतलब ये है, सबको योगा में जोड़ना, यही इसके पीछे मतलब था।
इस बार आपके मंत्रालय की तरफ से यहाँ रांची में क्या खास है?
खासी में यही तो है, कार्यक्रम होने के बाद बहुत कुछ सरकार की, लोगों की भी इच्छा होगी यहाँ जो कुछ योगा के लिए या आयुष के लिए जो कुछ चाहेंगे वो हमने कई स्कीम्स डिक्लेयर की हुई। जैसा हमने कहा कि 50 बेड हॉस्पिटल, हम एक एक जिले को एक हॉस्पिटल, 50 बेड हॉस्पिटल अलग अलग पैथी का, यानी अपने ही इंडियन सिस्टम मेडिसिन का, आयुष का ही हम देने जा रहे हैं। योगा के लिए हम सेंटर बनाएंगे और जरूरत पड़े और यदि कुछ हमें ज़मीन वगैरह दे दे तो एक नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ योगा, नेचुरोपैथी, आयुर्वेदा जो चाहे वो हम भी इसके लिए भी हम यहाँ सोचेंगे, करने का सोचेंगे, ताकि हमारी पैथी और इस राज्य में स्प्रेड हो जाए.
And bodies of six Air Force personnel who died in the AN-32 aircraft crash were shifted from the accident site on Thursday. The team, which had been searching for the plane wreckage and remains of those on board the aircraft, retrieved the six bodies along with the mortal remains of seven others from the crash site near Siang district. Over the past week, the Indian Air Force had been making efforts to retrieve the bodies from the crash site, but weather made it difficult to carry out air operations. The Russian-made aircraft with 13 members on board went missing on June 3rd, about 30 minutes after taking off from Jorhat in Assam for Menchuka in Arunachal Pradesh. The wreckage was located on June 11th. 2 days later, after carrying out extensive search operations, the IAF had declared that there were no survivors from the crash. And on to some weather news now. After a delay of almost a fortnight, the southwest monsoon finally arrived in Goa on Thursday. The Met Department predicted that strong winds with speeds reaching up to 40 to 50 kilometers per hour are likely to prevail over southwest and adjoining west central Arabian Sea on Thursday and Friday. The southwest monsoon is likely to hit Odisha on Friday. As per the state weather department, movement of a cyclonic circulation and formation of a low pressure area over the Bay of Bengal is facilitating the process, and it will pave way for arrival of monsoon in the state. Meanwhile, people of Rajasthan also received some respite from searing heat as parts of the state were lashed by rains ranging from 2 to 7 centimeters on Thursday. The weatherman has forecast light to moderate rainfall at isolated places in the state in the next 24 hours. And we wrap up today's edition of News Tonight with current weather update from across the country. Thank you for watching. Namaskar. We'll be right back.